Then why does your Instagram look different than mine?
I am not sure. These are mysteries that we're going to have to take to Instagram themselves.
Huh.
Perhaps we should add it into Instagram stories.
Wait. Well, let's go to your picture. I don't have a theory. No? No, that's next. That's a nice picture, by the way.
Interesting. Yeah, I like that picture.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to episode 46 of A Brew With You. I am one of your hosts, Blake Mickle, accompanied by the executioner himself, Danny 123 Brajas.
None shall pass.
I was thinking wrestling.
Oh, yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Do you think Gandalf would do that in the ring?
Gandalf?
He should have done that to the Balrog.
I mean, he probably did. I think he laid the smack down on the way down, but I think he just got too cocky at first.
So it's kind of like in wrestling when they jump off the corner there, and as they're falling, it's like a slow motion of Gandalf and the Balrog fighting when they're falling down the pit, but like, you know, boom, 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 and then bam on the mat. And
right.
Then Gandalf's like, 1, 2, 3. And then he rips off his beard and goes, ah.
I don't think he would rip off his beard. That just seems excessive.
But he's a wizard. He can just grow it right back. Or just, he has his beard in his head and just puts
maybe
his
beard
sticks back on.
Huh? Maybe his beard is fake.
Ooh, it didn't time us. Gotta time us to know how long this is. You say, wait, his beard is what?
Fake.
Oh, fake.
What if his beard was fake?
I think he would get.
Or what if it was just a magic beard?
That sounds like a good song title. Yeah. Magic Beard.
The Magic Beard? That also kind of sounds like an excellent name for a beer.
Oh, that's a... When we open up our brewery, which we're going to do, we're going to... We should put that in the back burner.
Yes.
Not the name of the brewery, but just name of a beer.
Name of
Magic
a beer.
Magic Beard. I like that.
Magic Beard.
I like that a lot. And so when someone...
We'll have to Google it and make sure it's not taken already.
Patent pending. Dude, that's a great idea.
Patent pending. Yeah. I think there's a little tiny bit more that goes into putting a patent on things and that, but hey, we can try.
If you say it on a Brew With You podcast, it's official, okay? So a lot of people can come on over, just say it, and shall be written, shall be done.
We're pretty much like notaries.
How you been recently?
Good. I've been living that office life. I've been...
Look at you, Mr. 9-to-5-er.
I have been through a series of nonstop interviews.
Execution.
Yeah, generally a title given to our beverage director, but passed over to me today because I just, unfortunately, a lot of people got passed into me and they did not get past me.
Can't get past the executioner. Right. You want to get to this bar, you have to come through me.
Obviously, I can't go into detail about it, but...
Hey, it's work.
It's work related, so I'm not going to share any specifics, but the only thing I can say is I had to say no. I had to pull a Randy Jackson and just be like, yeah, that's going to be a no for me, dog. Because they just, you know, we have specific requirements and the requirements weren't met.
I'm blanking out. Randy Jackson reference.
American Idol. Yeah, that's going to be a no for me, dog.
Oh, he's a bald guy?
Yes.
No. Yes. Bald. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
That's what he says. That's going to be a no for me, dog.
Yes.
And also
portrayed and done by Frank Reynolds. Danny DeVito and It's Always Sunny.
Oh, okay. God, I need to catch up on Always Sunny. I miss Always Sunny.
That episode was Dee's talent show, and that I don't even remember.
Oh, I remember that one.
Yeah, that was a couple of seasons back.
Oh, yeah.
But he played the role of Randy Jackson in that.
For any of you joining us for the very first time, A Brew With You is where Danny and I will try a beer for the very first time.
Sure.
And I'm thinking about this, but like we're not trying a beer. I mean, does that sound right? Do we try or try a new beer for the very first time? Or does that sound redundant? We try a new beer for the very first time.
I think trying something new for the very first time is a little redundant.
Yeah. So just say, do we try a beer for the very first time?
Yep.
Okay. Everyone got it. Just start over. Rewind. Just fixing the facts, errors, and errors on the fly. Right.
Sure.
Now. All right. Doing it again.
Correcting the grammar.
Yeah. Grammar, that is. For any of you joining us for the very first time, A Brew With You is where Danny and I will try a beer for the very first time while discussing random topics broken out Tuesday through Thursday on YouTube, with the whole episode being released on Friday. If you like what you see, like what you hear, like what you feel, go to patreon.com/bigdealblake to get this episode a week early, along with your other exclusive content perks and rewards and all that good stuff. How it works? Danny brought the beer this week, so I choose where to drink. And, you know, I just can't... I'm not watching as much as I'd like. I watch a little bit every day, but the Olympics are going on.
Oh, yeah.
I personally am a big fan of the Olympics. I know a lot of people don't care or they're bored with some events. I love the Olympics.
Sure.
So I'm going to say Olympics, then I'll explain a little bit more why. So let's just say... I'd say Olympics. I don't want to say Rio. I'm talking about all the Olympics.
Okay.
So, yeah. Olympics on yeah. three. One, two, three.
Olympics.
I'm a big fan. I love the fact of world competition.
Yes.
I love the fact... I brought this up when Jeff was on.
Consequently love the world domination, but please go on.
You are the executioner. I love the fact, like, a man or woman can run a race and say, I am the fastest man or I'm the fastest woman in the world. Like,
yeah.
Like, think about that. I'm going to say man because I'm a man. So, like, be like, I'm the fastest man in the fucking world.
Usain Bolt.
Isn't that crazy?
Yes.
Maybe they haven't done track and field yet. Is he running this year? I think he is.
He said that he is retiring after this year.
Yeah.
So if he wins it in again, he ends the career as the fastest man on the planet.
And then you look at like Michael Phelps, like he's what, 19 gold medals now? It's crazy.
I think 21.
Oh God.
Yeah.
He's won three more. Damn.
Cause after he, crushed, Laclos or whatever the guy from South Africa's name is, which that was the best watching that whole rivalry out.
Yeah, that was fun.
And I don't know if you've seen it, but my favorite picture by far is everybody has the still image. The Phelps face is great, and it's hysterical, but in the actual race, there's a picture of Phelps swimming. His focus is right forward, and they show it right in the next lane. The guy from South Africa is swimming and looking at Phelps, and he's behind him. And it's just like...
Oh, cool.
The caption on it winner's focus on what's in front. Winner's focus on the goal in front of him. Loser's focus on the winners.
Did Phelps write that?
I don't think so. But it's still an awesome quote and it's still an awesome picture. And I was just like, yes.
Yeah. I mean, Phelps, I mean, what a character too. You know what I mean? I remember when he was the first or second Olympics. It was the second Olympics. I remember that one. And they'd made the Goku gif out of him. That was really funny.
Yes.
That was really funny. He was really intense that Olympics too. He was really worked up. I think he swept that year too. He got old golds. But anyway, we talk about the Olympics and there's like some events that, like, I think the decathlon is one of the greatest events of all time. It's actually a subgroup in track and field where it's like you do all 10, you like do 10 events. And it's like, that's pretty much, to me, is like the definitive athlete right there.
Yeah.
It's like you can jump the farthest, jump the highest, run the fastest, throw the farthest. You know what I mean? It's like pretty much the definitive athlete.
Yeah.
I mean, in terms of... there's some things it's weird. Like the pentathlon's weird. Like it's so weird, the pentathlon. But again, you think about it, it breaks down so many different skill sets. So like how to shoot a gun accurately, you ride a horse, run a long distance. There's swimming, and then there's maybe fighting or like not fighting. That's
pretty much being a cowboy in a Western movie.
In a way. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's like, yeah, that's a great way of saying it. Yeah. It's called the cowboy event.
Yeah.
How to be a cowboy. They're probably roping some steer. Yeah. You know? that's so funny, Danny.
Who's got the best cowboy skills?
Oh, that's so funny. Should all do it in cowboy hats and flannel. All right. Well, you know, I have this love for the Olympics. I need to watch more of it. I think we still have another more than a week still, like 10 days. Wait, 7, how long is the Olympics? 10 days?
I think I want days, to 17 say, days? I want to say it goes through the 21st. I'm not 100% certain about
that. Yeah, 17 days. I think that sounds right.
Yeah.
So plenty more things to watch on that. So what do we got, Danny?
Well, speaking of cowboys, this is a Hefeweizen from Baderbräu here in Chicago called High Noon.
You brought me a Hefe. I love me some Hefes.
So Baderbräu is a brewery that has started off in Elmhurst, Illinois. It's changed ownership a handful of times, just very recently in 2010. Its current owner took over production. They kind of revamped some things with one of the original brewers from the company. They started production of just the classic Pilsner that they put out in 2012. 2014, they actually bought a warehouse, and just this year, that warehouse is a new brew pub for them in downtown Chicago off of South Wabash.
Lovely.
So since they have had a few years now, they've started putting out a different series of beers. And for me, because I'm not such a gigantic fan of Pilsners, usually just because it's like the most classic form of beer and there usually isn't a ton to them.
Nothing wrong with a standard, but I hear what you're saying.
I mean, I actually like their Pilsner quite a bit, so I've been looking to try some of their new stuff, and Hefeweizen sounded refreshing, as it has kind of been a warm couple of days for us.
It has been. A little toasty. I mean, like, yeah, not hot, like disgusting hot, but a little toasty.
Yeah.
I noticed it because you know why? We're having these days and there's not a cloud in the sky, so it's just direct sunlight hitting you. You know? Even if it is like only, it's not in the 90s, but it still is direct sunlight hitting you like that. Well, let's crack it open.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, I'll get into it in a second. I'm thirsty. That's why I want
to. Let's do it.
Yeah.
I love that sound. Classically, you know, you're in. Hefeweizen is a wheat beer. Wheat beers go by many names. Hefeweizen is
super wheaty.
Hefeweizen is a title for a style of wheat beer. Hefe is the German word for yeast, which generally means bottle conditioned beers, aka ale and lees, like we've heard before and learned about before on this show.
Sure.
Characteristics, you're going to have more fruity aromas coming off this. You're not going to get so much of the hop bitterness. Very generally, very low IBU counts. I didn't actually read the direct description on the bottle of this one. Those are just kind of classic profiles of it, but more often than not, more of a citrus taste, a lot of clove. You'll get spice on the finish in it. So did you already go for it?
I had like a sip only because it was foaming out. It was foaming.
The safe sip?
It was the foam, yeah. So, Mr. Ovia, sir.
Cheers.
Yes, very good.
Can we cheers to the Silver Surfer?
This is my favorite t-shirt in the whole wide world.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, cheers to the Silver Surfer. My favorite t-shirt. This is like one of my favorite all time. This is my Comic-Con t-shirt.
It's a great t-shirt.
Yeah, it's starting to wear down. I'm getting really scared because I need to get a final replacement. I haven't found a replacement. Let's drink the beer.
Yes.
That is a hefty. Well, this is right. This is the right beer for this time of year, man. It's very light, very definitely taste that the wheat taste. It's the most predominant flavor I feel. When you think Hefeweizen though, it tastes like this. I feel it's very standard Hefeweizen though. So it's my first impression right now. We'll see how it does in the long haul after this beer is done, but first impression, I'm not getting that robust flavor of wheat. It's just tastes very standard.
I didn't think of it until post, like right after we cracked the can. Traditionally with Hefeweizens, you do kind of want to mix them up a little bit prior to opening, usually.
I just want to do this. If you're just listening to the podcast, we're rolling the cans between our palms.
Gently between our hands. Mm. Now, traditionally, you want to do this because...
I got to gift this.
Bottle-conditioned beers... generally, that means there is some additional yeast strain in the bottom of the can. It causes, you know, a little extra fermentation, generally a little extra carbonation. But you want that to kind of mix into the beers. If you get a Hefeweizen that comes out that's like crystal clear, either it is filtered or it was poured wrong. Most of the time with Hefeweizens, that, you know, they're going to be unfiltered and you're looking for kind of that cloudy, hazy appearance.
Yeah. What I love about Hefeweizens is that it's... they're a little addicting out of all the beers. I just feel like I can just drink, just pour it down. Like IPAs, like sipping or in pacing myself. Hefeweizen, I just feel like it's like water. Not like it tastes watered down, but I just chug it.
Literally, they market some of their beers as crushable, which I mean, that's a hard definition of session beers. And this one is not heavy on ABV. No. I think it was it's 4.9. It's under 5%.
Yeah. Graphic design point of view, this is very interesting. This label is very like slapped on there. Did you notice this? It looks like, look at even at the top, it looks like there's a sticker on here.
Yeah, very much so.
Yeah, it's not like a part of the can or it's not like fused with it. It's kind of like slapped on there. It's really weird and very sloppily too. Very interesting.
You think that's a cost saving to not have to print the can?
Yeah, absolutely. Oh yeah. I mean, it's not, it's like so weird seeing a can below it that has nothing on it at all.
It's standard aluminum.
Yeah. This is an interesting choice, Danny. And for any of you who watched the preamble, we just released, well, it was last week if you're watching this now, but we released Johnny's trailer for Trailer Bait, Hell or High Noon, or Hell or High Water, I should say. Mm-hmm. I've seen High Noon on the bear. Hell or High Water, that's what I'm remembering. That. Another, that movie looks awesome, by the way. You watch that in the preamble, what we cover. It's starring Chris Pine and Ben Foster. And they're like two Robin Hood bandits in like modern Western movie. And Jeff Bridges is the sheriff.
All right. Everything about that seems like a movie that I would absolutely watch.
Yeah, it looks good. It looks really, and it's also the right.
Because I am not overly pumped about the remake of The Magnificent Seven.
For knowing you, Danny, like I want to be excited for you. I always have a little bit of mixed feelings towards Magnificent Seven because it's based off my favorite movie. You know what
yes.
I mean? And my favorite movie, it's the same premise, but I mean, well, I'm not thinking against the Magnificent Seven because I love Yul Brynner in that. And
Steve McQueen.
Steve McQueen, thank you. It's a good movie. I love it too. It's just that for me, you know, I like the original and it's a masterpiece. The original, it's a masterpiece. And I'm just, that's my biggest thing too with movies, man. I'm just tired of remakes. Like Magnificent Seven, why are we doing a Magnificent Seven? How about we have the same cast we have, but just not Magnificent Seven?
Right.
That's all I'm saying.
Can somebody just write me a new story?
Yeah.
Possibly Hell or High Water.
Ooh, that movie looks good. That movie,
it's not a remake, is it?
I don't think so. That's a good point. I have to look into that. So, Danny, I want to...
Raising all the right questions.
Oh, let's do some real quick fixing the facts, because I know it's going to be quick.
It is. It's going to be lightning fast. Actually, I will have to reference some notes for this one.
Okay.
So, we were with Andrew Wu last week.
Big props to Wu. He was a great guest, absolutely. And I really liked that show. I had a fun time with that show.
It was a lot of fun.
And... like I said, I can't say much, but Wu and I are working on, early talks of another show being on it to Big Deal Blake.
All right.
But I can't promise anything.
Most of that show, for those of you who did watch it, thank you for watching it. For those of you who did not watch it, you should probably watch it because it was a lot of fun to do. And Andrew is quite a character. He's awesome.
Yeah. We really enjoyed it too.
We hit a lot of topics that pertained to personal memories. it's been a long week already. All right. Anyways, I got called the executioner at work today, man. That's an inside joke that next time Blake does a Patreon exclusive, he'll explain that joke to you and what happened and why it was funny to us.
Yes, we will.
We did a lot of personal memories. We talked about Nintendo, which was tons of fun because how often do you get to just talk about old school Nintendo and your first memories that are surrounding one of the most game changing, pun intended, gaming systems of all time?
It's weird. I like talking about games. I just don't play them anymore just because of the time consumption, and it sucks.
Except for when you're walking to work.
Oh, but that's multitasking.
You gotta catch them all.
I do catch them all. I am trying, damn it. There's so many. I'm at like... out of 150 Pokemon, I'm closing in on 90, I think. Not bad.
You're going to get along great with the rest of my management staff. Every single one of them.
Speaking of which, reminder, we have to talk about it now. We got to talk about the end of the month, your soft opening. We got to talk about that. So remind me later, okay?
Yeah,
Don't forget. Remind me.
But really, early on, we were just kind of, shooting the shit. I was trying to look for a better phrase so that I didn't have to swear on your show, but whatever.
You can swear. Do you swear on the show, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, we do. We don't swear a lot, but
I drop an occasional F-bomb here and there.
I already swore this morning. Yeah. I swore this morning right when I woke up.
I woke
fucking good morning, wasn't it?
I wake up cursing most of the time. God.
Yeah, I'm still alive. I didn't die in passing.
Oh, that's rich. I'm going to add that just to let you know.
Sure. Yeah. No, by all means.
Go ahead. So what do we got? So what are you getting to?
So what I'm getting to is that really the only thing that we brought up that was kind of noteworthy, that now that I'm officially a patron for Big Deal Blake,
hey,
finally made it. Thank you, technology, for working with me on this one. And you had to adjust some settings on there. And just so you know, because we've talked about it a bit before, now the instant I type up Big Deal, you like the first one that pops up.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I'm really glad to hear that. And also, too, because I'm at actually a pace of getting a patron a month. And that is really heartwarming. It really is.
Yeah.
Technically, I don't have a job right now. So this is my job right now. So, I mean, I'm not getting much, but I mean, like...
It's my focus right now.
Be dedicating a lot of time to it.
I will. Yeah. Fuck yeah, I am. Yeah. Fuck yeah, I have the time now.
No reason not to.
I'm not getting paid, but I'm still, I love it. And that's what I, you know, and so that's, means a lot, buddy. It does.
Yeah.
I mean, you're on the show and you're still chipping a few bucks. So that's, sure. That's, that
absolutely.
Means a lot.
I mean, technically I could just sit here and illegally pirate every episode. I just take one long selfie.
You really want this episode? Or yeah. Really come talk to me.
Yeah.
I put it in my Instagram stories. The whole episode is my Instagram stories.
That's actually my Patreon account is just bootleg versions of our show.
Bootleg Danny. Yeah.
You never know what he's going to be doing next.
That's cool.
But anyways, because we just keep getting off topic about this, The only thing that really we made a joke about, slash we're like, oh, actually, we can fix that. We can look that up. But we said something about red hair, and you looked at Wu and you're just like, I actually heard that is a mutation, and we were trying to move topics. So you're like, yeah, we'll look that up later. Since really that was the only thing that I had to research, and I do love researching things, I researched it. Turns out, yes, it actually is a genetic mutation.
Gingers are X-Men.
Not unlike, you know, colored eyes or anything like that. So it basically, what it boils down to is that there is one of two chemicals that kind of cause either blondish hair or brunette hair. If you have more of one or the other, it usually will carry out the balance to either blonde or brunette.
Mm.
They are controlled by a gene called MC1R. If both of those are mutated, and sometimes it will stop the conversion of those two chemicals mixing to create either blonde or brunette hair, you end up with red hair. And that is it.
I find that, so they are mutated freaks. They are not supposed to happen.
I wouldn't go that far.
One of our good patrons has red hair.
I believe it's 1 in 4, I think is what was the statistics.
Of 4's Blake's patrons. One of every 4.
Makes sense. The numbers stack up.
Okay, I got to wrap this up. So we only had to fix one fact because Andrew Wu is a very, very, very smart man. And he doesn't say stupid stuff, unlike Danny and I. So luckily, there's nothing to fix. So thanks to me, you're welcome for getting it right. That I know that redheads are mutated.
Yeah.
I mean that in a good way. Okay. So I want to jump into this fast
because
we have topics to go to. But I don't care. We can figure this. So I got an email. You know what? Maybe I should just make this my topic, and then we'll see how. I don't know. You think I should just bring it into the topic?
If you can fold it in, fold it in. My topic is just kind of silly.
Well, let's start with yours then, and we'll do this, and then we'll start with yours. How about that?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. So we're gonna stop it now, and then we're gonna go to part two, Danny's topic, and then we're gonna before we start Danny's topic, we're gonna introduce a little live action here with some apps,
some things. Yeah.
All right. So. Let's continue on with this goofiness, then Danny's topic right now.
Woo.
Okay.
All right.
So I got an email. And the CEO or whoever of this app called Saucy. And if you don't know what Saucy is, it's an alcohol delivery service. When I first heard about it, I was tweeting about it. I'm like, I'm going to die from this. Like, I'm going to die. And honestly, I've only used it once because I just wanted to see how it worked, right?
Sure.
It works great.
Yeah.
It's very time. When I use it, I ordered like a six-pack of Modelo, just like whatever.
Sure.
Just to see how it worked out. The only problem is because it's delivery, it's expensive.
Right.
We're talking like, here, I have the app open right now. So, like, for example, a 12-pack of Bud Light is $13. A six-pack, here, that's a bad example. A six-pack of Goose Island 312 is $12.
Yeah.
It's a little bit high. It's not like $20 for it, but it's definitely high.
That's heightened. I feel like you should be able to get a six pack of 312 for like the $8 to $9.
Exactly what I was saying. $8.99 is what I was going to say. $8.99. So yeah, little pricey. Ooh, they got Sophie. I love Goose Island Sophie. Matilda's better though.
How much is the Sophie?
Sophie for a four pack, which you all know Sophie Matilda four packs
is $14, which is not that bad.
That's not bad.
That's not bad.
Yeah, that's not bad at all.
That's premium good shit right there.
Yeah.
So I got this email from, I forgot to do something. Shit. I got to set my time on this. I'm doing so much on my phone right now. Wait.
Waiting for it.
Okay, cool. Now I have to set my time for this topic. Sure. Even though I'm cutting into your topic time. But you said it's goofy, so it's okay.
Yeah.
And we're doing a goofy thing right now, too. So.
We do like silly things.
Yes. Oh, I can actually, if you don't have Saucy, I can sign you up and get $10, too. That's fun. Share with friends, drink for free. Give 10, get 10. That's cool. All
right.
So I got an email from Saucy, and they said, you haven't used your account in a while. They're still trying to launch it. So they just gave me $20 free.
Oh, yeah.
$20.
Yeah.
For like free. So right alone. Yeah, the price are escalated. So I thought it'd be fun. And this expires in 2 days. And I just got this email. So I'm like, well, why don't we just do it for the show and see what happens? So right now it is 8:09 p.m. And I'm going to put an order in. So Danny, what do you want to order? I already put a couple of personal items in the bag because I get $20 off.
You're passing on things.
No,
I don't have particulars. Get whatever you're going to need for your place, for the Olympics. What kind of supplies are you going to need to watch Phelps dominate the 200 meter?
Ooh, do you think, what do you think Phelps drinks? Because, you know, they're athletes. He's not drinking during the Olympics.
I know what he smokes.
Hey, you know what? I
never faulted him for that.
Yeah, you know what? He was like 20-year-old kid who tried, right. Or I don't even know if it was the first time he hit.
Okay, real fast. The other thing is, honestly, all these Russians who are doping in the Olympics, they are still competing. Obviously, they got in plenty of trouble for it, but you know, the commission allowed them to still compete. Michael Phelps smoked some weed. That is not enhancing his performance in the slightest, and he is still.
There was an argument that they were enhancing his performance. Weed was.
I don't know. I
thought it was just an illegal substance.
I'm presuming illegal substance, but even if it is illegal, that is actually hindering his performance. Why did he get blasted so hard for that? Like, I never understood that. I was like, yeah,
it's garbage.
I was like, that's so dumb. And he still comes back and crushes it. So this is even more reason to like him.
Have you ever had Four Roses whiskey? I never had it before. I've heard mixed things.
I don't think that I have.
All right. Well, I'll try some. Never, like, I just recognize the bottle. Have you seen this bottle?
Absolutely.
But you've never had it?
Never tried
it. Then let's try it. Trying new things. I'm all about this right now. We have a lot to talk about that we can't talk about on the podcast, unfortunately. Stories, everybody. Stories.
Ooh.
And we're best friends, so we have to talk about, you know, stuff that's not going to be out in the internet land.
Unless you subscribe to Bootleg Danny.
Okay. So I am getting... Okay. So I'm going to order this now. Let me see. I'm just... Spend $11,676 more for a free delivery. How much is the delivery fee? The tax is $4. Delivery fee. I got a little something extra in there, so it's not skewed. So I'm buying Four Roses for $30. A couple of items for myself. So the tax is
How much do they want you to spend for a free delivery?
They want me to spend a total of $60.
Okay.
For a free delivery.
What's the delivery price? What's the delivery charge?
Delivery. So the tax is $4.40 and the delivery fee is $3.
Oh, dude, if you got $20 off, I wouldn't
add another item on there. Or
I would not spend $3 on delivery and you're getting 20 off your whole order.
So you're saying this is good right here. So this is what I'm getting.
I think I would not go out of my way to spend another $30 or whatever it is to meet 60 if you could just pay $3 to get it delivered and still have $20 promo off.
All right, I'm checking out. So we're ordering right now Four Roses barrel strength whiskey. Never had it before. With this age verification, you must provide a valid government ID when I buy it. Okay, so I have to bring my license when they commit. I'm submitting it. This happened last time. It was a very nice Latino woman. She said, can I see your ID? And she's like, this is silly. I know you're fine. I'm like, oh, you're fine. Here you are. You're adorable. Okay, I just got the text message. We received your order at 8:12. It took me 3 minutes to order that. That's not long at all.
Now, see, that's going to be the interesting thing about trying to launch something like this.
Okay, it says we'll see you under an hour. So they might not deliver it during this podcast because we'll be done in an hour So who knows?
Right. More often than not with delivery services, they're always going to overquote you in effort to beat that time.
Sure.
It's Olympics, hashtag Rio, because that is subconsciously just a way to make people happy without them really thinking it. If a pizza place tells you that it could be up to an hour and a half and you just put it at 2 hours in your head and not think about it, and then it shows up in 45 minutes, you'd be like, oh, this is awesome. I'm going to call this place every time.
What do you think the world record is for alcohol delivery time?
I'm going to go with, ooh, we should just do an over under.
Ooh, yeah.
I would go with the world record.
Yeah.
If they're quoting you an hour.
They quoted me an hour.
They quoted you an hour. I'm going to go with 36 minutes.
36 minutes. Okay. That's the world record. So 36 minutes. And then, okay, I'm going to say.
If this person beats 36.
I'm going to say 27. No, I'm going to say 27 minutes. That's a short window for us. I'm going to widen. I'll go crazy. I'll say 24 minutes. I'll say 24 minutes
from now.
The beer, our four roses will be here. Even though it's a beer drinking show, we ordered whiskey. I just realized that.
Are we going to give the driver a gold medal?
I was about to say golden beer. Yeah. I was going to give them the golden beer. So 24 minutes from now. Let's see. You could do it at home. This topic's going to go longer than shorter than 24 minutes. Or maybe we should just make it go long, this topic, just for the sake of it.
Just for the sake of seeing what happens?
We'll see what happens. So thanks for using Saucy Order Place, blah, blah, blah.
No, Saucy. Thank you.
Oh, wait. I'm going to see if they got the right address here. Shit.
Ooh.
Wait.
You should...
No, they got it right. No, it's the right address.
You should sign up your account as a business if you can. You probably can't because of distribution laws. They probably wouldn't allow a business to sign up. But you should sign us up under the name of the show.
So... you know how we called up... you saw the episode when we called up Stupid Wit?
Yes.
I never asked you about that. What do you think about that?
About the phone call or the beer?
The phone call.
I think that's pretty fucking cool.
It was very nice. Yeah. I was like, I mean, your woman was literally thrown off on the spot there, but I'm like, props to you, Lagunitas. I was like, that was really cool. I want to do that more on the show, by the way. I want to find, if they have a number like that, I want to do it.
Just start calling breweries. Hey.
The order has been confirmed, ladies and gentlemen. So we could check our times actually right here. See?
Yeah.
So, all right. Danny.
Yes.
While we're waiting, hopefully it will be delivered. We could put them on the spot. For under an hour on the show, so we could see and see who's right here. You had said 37, you said?
36.
You said 36, and I said 24. Okay. What's your topic, buddy?
So I don't know why this thought ran into my head the other day, but I found myself just really thinking about it like way too much. And I was just like, this might actually be kind of fun just to talk about for fun's sake.
Okay.
Yeah. We got the Olympics going on. We got a lot of heavy competition going on.
I saw some judo the other day, too. I forgot
some
to mention
judo
that.
Judo going on.
Fucking awesome. Yeah. USA just took this guy down. It was awesome.
Anywho. I've been working quite a bit. I mean, we're pretty long hours, but it's also, I get... totally preoccupied there, doing what I'm doing. This is what I do, darling. Interviews and things like that. But I just wanted to know if you had an exorbitant amount of money and you were going to build your own gigantic palace. What is...
Dude, this is... go on.
What is the room that you would spend the most money on and why?
I love this topic. Okay. Which I think was really funny. Recently, when our good friend Jason had a goodbye party, and he's going to Providence, and we're gonna visit him out there and annoy him. It's gonna be great.
Definitely
next year. We were just talking about this because one of the people we met. One of the people we met. Oh, something happened on my phone. Was it a notification? What was it?
Saucy.
Oh, I'm gonna win this bet. 13 minutes.
What?
Saucy, good props. You were on. You were even tested. You said under an hour. We were guessing 20 plus. You get 13 minutes. Ooh, that was...
Sorry.
That went everywhere. So at this party...
Doesn't normally happen like that.
Oh, you're here. I'll get you. Hold on.
You got a little messy there?
A tiny bit. It's not a big deal.
Thank you, Dan.
So are you going to have a medal ready for Saucy?
This is
like Saucy just took over as the fastest beer delivery on the planet.
Yeah, even though we should have ordered. You know what I thought of? We thought of it too late because Danny already brought the beer over. And then I just got the email when we started the show. That'd have been cool if we did this and to see how long we can do this show without the beer.
Right.
We should do that next time. Put him on the test again and see. Like, we're doing a podcast. We don't have beer yet. That'd be fun.
Yeah.
We want to have an exotic beer, though.
You gotta tag them in this episode.
Oh, I'm tagging them. Oh, absolutely. Yeah. For this episode right now? Hell yeah.
It's a must.
Absolutely. So, really funny that at this party that we did this good party for Jason, there was a woman there who, I don't know her official title, but she said she's a garden designer. and she, one of her clients is Billy Corgan.
Really?
Yeah. And I was like, holy shit. So I was like telling her that one of my fantasies is of like, if I had a mansion, all the money, blah, blah, blah. I would love to have a backyard, have a Greek mythology theme. And I'm talking about like a giant fountain with Neptune on it, with all his like the horses beneath him and him commanding the water there.
Yes.
And then like all these marble statues of Greek gods, and then they're shaped in the plants, like the hedge maids sort of thing. And there's elements. So there's a hedge. Well, actually, I'll have a hedge mage, and then there will be like the Minotaur will be in the hedge mage, like just like the Theseus.
Will it come to life?
I haven't decided yet. I have to think about that later because I can't do any fire or anything because there's plants. So right. I have to think about that. So I was talking about that. I would love to have this Greek mythology themed garden. I would love that. I think that'd be so badass and so, because I love, if you don't know this about me, I'm a big Greek mythology fan. I know a lot about it. It was one of my favorite things. It wasn't really like, it was history, but it was a small part of history that I was like infatuating with growing up.
I was actually just telling a friend the other day that I really wish that we could kind of go back to the multi-god system in Greek mythology.
I know.
And she's like, well, why don't you just start practicing it and see what happens at work? And I was just like, oh yeah, no, they'll just be like, Danny, what are you doing? Hey, making a sacrifice to Hades. What do you think?
Yeah. 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 Dominos. That's one of my favorite, not favorite, but
don't you guys know that it's the second spring solstice?
Mel Brooks, everybody. Hey, Danny, the Christians are so poor.
How poor are they?
How poor are they?
Their Christians are so poor, they only have one God. Mel Brooks, man. It was, it's the Romans.
Oh, yes.
It was,
Romans. Yes.
It was fun. I love that shit. So I had a lot of thoughts about this, about my Greek mythology garden. I would love to be this high baller and just have this Greek mythology garden.
How big of a space are we talking about, though? Like, how big
we're
of a
We're talking
garden?
Big.
We're talking, like, acres?
Like, maybe an acre.
Okay.
An acre's a lot, though.
An acre is a lot.
I'm saying, like, an acre, though.
Yeah.
I think I can get a hedge mage, my fountain, my statues. Also, if I'm going to like really go like fucking crazy, I would like to have like a mini Coliseum, you know, that'd be cool. Even though that's Roman, but still, I like to like have, like a lot of the games they played, like the wrestling pits or something like that. That'd be cool.
I think the Coliseum would be Rome, but a Coliseum in general,
yeah,
you would find those in Greece.
Absolutely.
Definitely. Olympus. That's where they held the first Olympics, at the base of Mount Olympus.
That's why we get the Olympics. Yeah, yeah. You know, that's why the Athens, Greece. You know, it was they were the first one to host it, and for the 100-year anniversary, it was in Athens again. And then they went bankrupt because of it, not just because of the Olympics, but the Olympics really hurt.
Yeah,
poor Greece. They are really bad. That's really bad over there. Anywho, so the garden. Now, if you want to get technical. That's not a room.
True. To be honest, I think I've been struggling. I struggled when I had this thought, I struggled between the kitchen and the bathroom. Those were like the two.
What?
Yeah.
Really? Please go forward with this because I would not. Go ahead with that.
I just always have always thought it would be awesome to have like a restaurant style kitchen in a home. Like, it doesn't have to be, like, a huge one, but...
That would be cool. That would be very cool.
I would absolutely adore, and obviously you'd have to have a hood system put in, basically a huge exhaust fan, but I would absolutely adore having a grill right next to a flat top and, like, two small baskets with deep fryers in them just to have at all times. Like, that would be...
Your fancy imagine doing deep fryers. I love it.
So
you're, like, the one with the kitchen from the show Chopped. Like, like a mini version of that, pretty much.
Pretty much.
Yeah, you got everything you need there.
Yeah. Just, like, separate produce coolers.
Yeah.
You know? I'd have Cambros
everywhere. Would you have someone, like, you hire someone just to maintain the kitchen, make sure everything's clean, not expired, and, like, everything's up to date?
Like, once a week.
Okay.
I think once a week you could bring in somebody to do that, but for me, I enjoy cooking quite a bit just as a side thing, and I don't know. I think that would be just the coolest thing to have. And then if you actually looked into kitchen technology, like some of the induction like stovetops and things like that are just super badass looking. But then again, there's the bathroom.
Okay, so before we get to the bathroom, which I can add on to this, but I could see more what you're saying. Like, this is see, for me, I'm not thinking like, I think you're thinking like a little bit more resourceful, a little bit more practical in terms of, not practical is not the right word because it's not a practical topic, but more of a,
it's not a practical kitchen to have at home.
Exactly. Like, yeah, at all. I think you're finding like a lot of good reasonings why to have some things, because you could actually get good use of that kitchen, knowing that, one, I know you would cook, or you can cook, and two, you could actually like use this stuff. For me, it's like a Greek mythology garden. Like, I don't need that at all. That's just me. Just like, I have money that I'm coming out of my ears, and I'm going to everybody else.
Yeah.
I love Eddie Izzard, by the way. He's a comedian. Anyway. Yeah. You're a little bit more. Like, it makes more, like, you're using something that you would actually use, though. It's actually something, it's not just like a painting or something like that. It's, you would actually use it.
Right.
Interesting. So go on with the bathroom now, which I could see a little bit more on this side of your story.
On this side of the realm. I mean, think of just, we've all seen the show Cribs. Generally, there is.
2 minutes.
Is that Saucy?
2 minutes.
What was the total time on Saucy? Do we know? We need updates. We need updates on this time.
Absolutely right. Okay, so wait.
Give us.
I'm sorry, your topic is getting chopped up by Saucy.
No,
but I think
fine.
This is fun.
This
and is it's, just, you're right. It's a silly topic.
It's a silly topic.
It's a good topic though. Okay, so this is what
the
I hate.
World
about,
needs
this is what
to
I
know.
Hate about the freaking texting on the phone.
Should arrive in 13 minutes.
But then, when did this arrive?
8:16. You can slide this way and get. A time.
Never knew that.
Oh, just learned something new about iPhone, did you?
Dude, I never knew that.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
All you gotta
do something.
All you gotta do is slide left and you can get a timestamp on
you
the text.
You get your text, you just click on the text and you slide the left and the numbers show up. That's, yeah. So they said 13 minutes at 8:16. I just got a text saying 2 minutes away and it's 8:23 p.m.
All right. Does the math add up?
Absolutely.
Yeah. There you go.
Absolutely. Let's see. So 13 minutes would have been... 8:29. Yeah, it's actually gonna be faster than 13 minutes. They said 13 is gonna be faster than that.
Saucy keeps crushing its own records.
Oh my god, this is where we get the golden beer award. Yeah, you gotta get the golden whiskey award now. Get a golden blue label award. What's a really golden Dom Perignon? That's really expensive.
That is. I'm trying to think champagne.
Go on with the bathroom. When this, I don't know where they're gonna be, so. I have to think about this too. Like,
we're gonna have to.
I have to get my wallet too because I have to show my ID.
We're gonna be nice and ready for this and prepared.
Yes, you gotta. I don't know if you're. We're gonna see how what you do if you talk some. You know, don't have dead air, but you're gonna talk. I have to pick it up, or otherwise I'll just cut it. I'll just do a jump cut. Either way, we'll see how you do.
I might be breakdancing on top of this table when you get back with the Olympics behind me.
Ooh, you'd be breakdancing with Kerry Walsh and the volleyball pits. That's hard to breakdance on sand, but you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, yeah, it'd be pretty hard to break dance on sand. The bathroom. I just feel like we've all seen the show Cribs, and maybe this is part of the reason why I started thinking about this ridiculous topic. Not that I was watching Cribs, but I've seen plenty of it. But there's just something to me. That
I always laugh when you say Cribs because I have a funny story. Go ahead.
There's just something to me that is so unbelievably decadent about just a posh bathroom. Like, I've always wanted to have one of those, like, walk-in showers.
It's the first time ever you said posh on this show, I think.
I think that's the first time ever that I've said posh in life. That, you know, the one of those walk-in showers that has, like, 6 shower heads in it.
Oh, my God.
That has,
I want
like, a stone
fucking,
floor.
I want a faucet for every crevice of my body.
Right?
You know what I'm saying? I want to walk in and just have my arms extended and just every crack, crevice part of my body has its own water stream hitting it. Hell yeah, yeah.
So
I do.
This is, and when I was a member at Lakeshore, they totally redid the fourth floor locker rooms. Didn't use them often. However, they had like brand new showers with the called a rain shower head. So it's like that giant shower head that sits right above you and just like
I had
rains
one of those.
On you.
I used to have one.
Yeah.
There. Yeah.
Amazing.
I used to.
And then the walk-in bathrooms, you could create like one of those with like 4 of those rain
shower
heads.
Yeah, that's sexy. You know, if you didn't know, we shoot in my apartment. My bathroom No, we're shooting at the Olympics.
The Olympics.
Duh.
We are in
what
Rio.
What up, Carrie Walsh? I just high-fived Carrie Walsh. What's up? We just high-fived her because she just spiked the shit out of the Swedes right now. What
there
up?
Is sand all over me.
Yeah. So I'm fine with that.
Yeah.
America. The bathroom. I like my bathroom in this apartment a lot. It's a good bathroom.
Yeah.
I mean, I got a there's a glass shower. I got a tub and a stacked washer and dryer in my bathroom, which is nice.
Yeah, you got a good amount of space in there, which has classically like kind of been the problem with my apartments. Even though the one I live in currently has everything that I need it to have, the bathroom is still a bit small to me. Still a tad small.
In your new place?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I would agree with that too. I would agree with that too. That's so funny. Hey, we got Emilio delivering.
Emilio!
Oh! Quack. 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 That was two different movie references in the same name.
I can make you famous.
Yeah.
There's a third.
Come on, Saucy. You said 13 minutes. How are they doing?
Hey. Let's not hate on Saucy, all right? Saucy is very, very
I'm not hating. I'm not hating.
Far exceeding.
He said 13 minutes. Now they're at the 13-minute mark.
Okay.
You know
even so, they're still far exceeding our expectations and blowing their original quota time out of the water right now.
That's right.
Yeah.
They said under an hour, and we're at 13 minutes.
If Saucy had NBC's Yellow World Record line in front of it, it would be like neck and neck with
yeah,
it.
We got the yellow line. There is a fly flying in this fucking apartment, and it's driving me crazy right now.
Yeah, I was wondering how long it was going to take you to.
No, I've just been doing it for a while until I burst it out.
Yeah,
until I mentioned it. Ugh.
I mean, we are in Rio.
Oh, there's a lot of flies. Yeah, in Rio, aren't there?
Insects. Yeah. Insects are going to be around.
Mm-hmm.
Just things that you have to deal with when you are at the Olympics, Blake.
I'm all about the bathroom. This is where we can find our mutual bathroom. Agreement where if we had any rooms in the place, I mean, I would have a room to like my honestly, like my ideal place, I would have like a really nice place. I'd have like it looking good, like it would be nice,
yes,
stuff, right? I'm talking about like the carpeting, the decor, it would all complement each other, probably classically, but hear me out. I would definitely like to have a room, though, which is like my man cave.
Yes.
I would like to have, like, actually, if I had all the rooms, I would like to have a room that had, like, all my dork comic book side of me. I'd like to have a room that's all sports-related stuff, like sports memorabilia and whatever. I'd like to have another room that's all internet-based culture. I would like to have all that on there. Like, what I mean by internet, like, I have, like, this, like a studio, in a way. Like
yeah.
A studio.
One last thing about the bathroom, and again, you probably expected me to talk about a man cave with all kinds of ridiculous things in it. Nope, bathroom. I did always think that it would be cool to, like, in a guest bathroom, and I'm not just saying, like, you'd have to spend it on one room. Like, if it was bathrooms, like, you know, it's one genre of your house. But I always thought it would be cool to, like, if on the first floor of your house where you have, like, the guest bathroom or whatever, the half bath, like,
the one
that everybody goes to.
Like when I had my old townhome.
Yeah, the one that everybody goes to.
Yeah.
If you had it set up, like, a public restroom. So there's, like, there's like three urinals, there's, like, three stalls, there's, like, a long sink, you know, mirrors, like, vanity lights,
sure.
Automatic soap dispensers.
There's a bar, I can't remember where it is, I honestly, then it was, I didn't know if it was even mentioned where or what restaurant it was or where it was located, what city, but for the guys' bath part, I don't know what it's like for the women, for the guys, for all the urinals, there's a two-way mirror above the urinal, so you actually look out to the restaurant when you're peeing. Isn't that crazy?
Yes.
Think about that, though. It's like everyone just sees the mirror when they're sitting down eating, so they don't think about it. But like when they're peeing, they look out to the restaurant. Isn't that weird?
That's a little bit weird, yeah.
But I mean, like, at the same time...
You're not seeing anything.
I don't know. It's kind of weird at the same time. I don't know. I like it, but I don't like it.
You don't like a bunch of people who are peeing watching you eat?
I'm fine with that, but in a public setting... Emilio, what's going on, man? Oh, there it is.
Emilio is calling.
All right, hold on.
You must heed the call.
This is Blake. All right. No, do you just stop right at the alleyway there, and I'll be right out. I'll be right out. I'll sign you. Bye, bye. All right, that's really perfect timing, Danny, because we can end this topic right now. So we can cut.
Yeah.
But there's still going to be some dead air for the full episode that we released to patreon.com/bigdealblake so you can get the whole episode early. So let's see how you do why don't you dance, monkey, dance?
Yeah.
And I'm going to pick up the saucy order. So that took...
what was the total time?
I'll make it official when we get back.
Sure.
Okay, I'll let you know.
Not a problem. Have fun. It's going to be great.
Oh, hello. We're back.
Howdy.
All right, I'm going to rate Emilio 5 stars.
Just like Estevez.
Oh, I have to tip him. I don't have to tip him. Should I tip him?
Should probably tip him.
I mean, it was a $3 delivery fee.
It's a
and also they overcharge for. Well, so, hey, talk to you, Mr. Industry.
All right, so the price hike is definitely to cover their costs. What probably happens is he buys it, he gets reimbursed for the cost of it. The company keeps that price hike. I would guess that the delivery charge should go to him to cover gas and mileage. But any additional money he probably gets through tips.
So 20.
That would be my guess.
20?
That would be my guess.
All right. He's a nice guy. $20.
There you go.
20% tip.
Yeah, I mean, if I was running a kind of a similar business, that would be my basic breakdown of it.
Okay, Saucy. So what happened? Wait, did it deliver? No. Okay.
I'm guessing that they don't. I'm guessing they don't have a warehouse with all these products at hand where somebody goes and picks them up and then drives them. It doesn't seem feasible.
We are in the city of Chicago. We placed an order at 8:16. They said your delivery will come in under an hour. I received a text message at 8:16. The time now is 8:36. 20 minutes, we got our bottle of Four Roses bourbon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. It's a beer drinking show, but we said, hey, we're getting whiskey now. Because if I give it $20 off, I'm going to buy the good stuff, right?
Yeah.
And they give you these little tags on all the booze they deliver.
Is it like a saucy business card?
Yes. That was very posh of you to say.
So fetch.
I'm curious to see what you said to the camera. Fetch. I have to watch it though now. So I don't know where I'm going to put this on the topic right now. Oh, but all right. No, I'm going to leave. So I'm going to add this to the front of it. I think. I don't know. Maybe I'll just put it in the blueberry reel at the end.
Yes.
You did it at the blueberry reel. You think we should do that?
Yeah, probably.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Okay. So alcohol may be man's worst enemy, but the Bible says, love your enemy. Frank Sinatra.
Ah, all right.
They have a different quote. I don't remember the last one they had. I think it was a Benjamin Franklin quote about beer or something like that in the last one. But they have these on all the things they deliver. Would you like to try some Four Roses? I know we're doing High Noon, but you know, like a little sip?
Yeah, I would do a little taste of the Four Roses.
So I don't know what you talked about before when I was gone, but this is good for you. This is what I need to do more. This is what I want to do on the Big Deal Blake show. Oh, I just ruined the idea for the new show. I want to do the Big Deal Blake show.
Spoiler alert.
I want to talk to the camera more. So I'm going to get 2 glasses. So this will take 20 seconds. Go.
Okay. So Four Roses whiskey. It's a bourbon. I do like bourbons. I don't know much about it. I am down to try new things all the time. The fact that this place is called Saucy, I mean, that's pretty legit. I like it, but we'll find out again, what kind of products they deliver. Obviously Blake liked Emilio and gave him a 20% tip, which is why we're buddies, because Blake knows how to tip people, which is a very good plus. Yeah. All right. Well, I still continue to drink beer. I'm sorry. It's just going to happen. I'll go neat.
Oh, in?
Yeah.
I mean, I like chill. Neat?
Yes. That's actually one of the best Valentine's Day pictures that I ever got sent, which was actually from Vic. He sent it out and tagged a bunch of us. He posted it and tagged a bunch of us in it. And it is a whiskey glass with some ice cubes in it, looking at a whiskey glass that is neat. And the whiskey glass with ice cubes says, I think you're neat. It's great.
I love it. How's that? That good?
Yeah, it's perfect. Okay. Just a little taster.
I like a little chill with mine.
Wet the whistle?
I've heard a lot about Four Roses. To tell you the truth, Four Roses makes this batch of extremely, extremely elite bourbon that gets 5 out of 5 stars across the board. It's like one of the highest rated bourbons of all time. You can see it on so many. People shoot fireworks around here, and fireworks went off.
Or guns.
Guns too. That's Chicago.
Yeah.
Not this part of Chicago, fortunately. Yeah, so Four Roses apparently has this like extremely elite rare batch. We're talking like thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars. And it's extremely rare, and I don't know where you can get it, but it's the highest like rated bourbon. I'll look into that more. You can fix the facts on this, Dan.
Sure.
Cheers to the second to Four Roses and to Saucy. This is to Saucy.
And Emilio.
For giving me $23. And Emilio. Saucy and Emilio. For giving me $23. And I use your service. And I think it was a guinea pig because they gave me $10 last week and it expired in 2 days.
Yeah.
And I didn't use it. So now they gave me 20 and I used it. So like
maybe instantly.
Yeah, instantly. So
a lot of people now are probably getting $20 offers.
Yeah, I hope so.
Well, and again, like a delivery service or a third party, like kind of ride there. It's almost like a ride share. Uber started out giving people $20 for every referral. Like, for a while there, I had like $60 in Uber referral credits, which was awesome. And now they only give you a free ride up to $20. So if you don't save it for like a long ride, you just use it on like a...
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
So you can
waste... It's like one ride. It's not like you can save it into your account. And $5 here, yeah.
Yeah, you can waste that on like a $3 ride, or you make sure that you play your cards
right. Go to the airport. Yeah. Just use it for the airport.
Yeah.
Cheers to Saucy. Cheers to Emilio.
All
right. A little sippy. Okay. This reminds me of this whiskey I get. It's called G&W. It's a very cheap whiskey, but it's very good on the flavor. This is good. It's not Bullet or Makers, but this will do the job. We have now become a whiskey with thee.
the transition show.
Eh? That's a spinoff show. We got to get a whiskey master. Hmm. That'd be a harder show to do. There's way less whiskeys out there than beer.
Yeah. Not to mention, I just don't think that you could spend an hour just continuously drinking whiskey. I was just reading the legend of Four Roses.
Okay.
But it doesn't really tell us much about the bourbon.
All right. Thank you again, Saucy. This is a pleasant surprise, and I pretty much got a free, not free, but I got a whole bottle of booze for, what, $10? That's not bad at all.
Yeah. That sounds outstanding.
So, Danny.
So, Blake.
My topic. Well, luckily we cut some time off of the Saucy thing and blah, blah, blah. My topic, it's tough for me to word this, so I need your help as much as you can.
The wordsmith.
My apologies for not telling you this beforehand.
Sure.
Show because we said we were going to, and I didn't, and it slipped my mind. So.
We got really saucy.
Saucy.
I just like that's the name they picked for the app.
That's great.
Yeah.
It works. So now are you going to... Actually, I should refer you so I can get $10.
Yes.
That's what I was going to suggest. We can do this again.
More free stuff.
Yeah. So I'm going through a lot of... I am... ongoing joke we have. It's fireworks, Danny. It's not guns. It's fireworks.
It's Chicago. There's legitimate Rio. It's Rio. There's legitimate cause to be concerned.
I understand. I'm going, an ongoing joke we have on the show is being even Steven, with a lot of good things are going on and at the same time, some rough stuff's going on. I am an even Steven right now. I'm going through some really weird stuff, but really good stuff at the same time. Like really good stuff and then really not so good stuff. So I'm even Steven.
Sure.
So that's why I think I'm just in high spirits. I'm wearing my Silver Surfer t-shirt, my favorite t-shirt, bring the positive vibe out.
Yeah, well, I do enjoy a good positive vibe.
I wanted to open up a little bit. See this at the end, more serious topic. So I'm a contractor, and my contract's up. I got no work. Okay. Now, it's not like, oh my God, panic, what do I do? I've been in this boat many, many times before.
Sure.
And I'm a contractor, and I could get a job tomorrow just like that. My agencies can call me up and say, oh, okay, we know you're done. We've been holding this off. You're the man for the job. It's a weird life, contractor, because I could be out of work for a month. I could be out of work for a couple hours.
Right.
But so I can't really go into detail about this. So I'm going to reveal a little bit more information than I was intended. But when I left my office, I was surprised that there were there was a person who is a hard worker and not an emotional person at all. And this person never stresses, never really shows negative emotion when they're working. If you give them a project, they're, yeah, no problem. If there's a lot of crap going on, they're like, oh, we can handle it.
Right.
And this person really opened up to me and saying, like, they're really going to miss me. I don't know what I'm going to do without you, sort of thing, that you're not here anymore. You were my mentor, my guidance. And I got a little emotional and I was like, it's going to be fine. You're going to be great. And I got to cut off there. You get the idea, right?
Sure.
Okay. You got the idea.
Yeah.
So my topic is this. It's kind of like saying, don't judge a book by its cover. That's what I think is the simple way to say it, is that you have this perception that this coworker was kind of a tough cookie I saw, and this person is a tough cookie. And you saw a side to them you never saw before. And I don't know if it's a judging book by its cover, but at the same time, it's just you're seeing a different side of this person or this.
Right.
Or as one of my good friends, patron and trainer, Jeff Stewart says, you know, like, we're people. We need to talk. We need to talk about shit that goes on in our lives. You know,
communication is clutch.
You know, we have to reveal some stuff.
The cadet's logic is sound.
Yes. So, yeah.
Good?
Yeah. Going.
Gonna so cut my, this then, up later so what and I'm save trying to fish.
Think, yes. Don't get, we gotta, you know, save the fishies. Thanks, buddy.
Yep.
So how's that beer? So I'm saying, if there was a time ever, friend, family,
foe.
Coworker, foe. Exactly. Foe. This is a great example for a foe. Yeah, I know you were joking, but like, seriously, where I can think of an example of a foe where it's like, I was taking an improv class right now. Not now. I was taking a class years ago, and I thought this one guy was an absolute dick.
Okay.
And just how his actions were, how he dressed, how we talked about his past. And then when I actually, over time, when we sat down and we opened out about each other, I was like, what the fuck? You are completely opposite. You are the coolest dude. And it's just like, yeah, it's just, I get that. Maybe it's just how my impression, or sometimes I get nervous, so I say things that I don't mean to say. And it really, I find that interesting. You know what I mean? And so yeah. I don't want to say judging book by its cover, not really, because judging book by its cover is like, usually you see, is more like an appearance thing where you see someone very, very dressed up, all preppy and nice, but they end up being like a huge dork video gamer or something like that. That's judging book by its cover. Or this woman wears like all black goth, but she's a fucking executive for an accounting firm. You know what I mean?
Right.
Just saying, don't judge a book by its cover.
Okay.
But for what I'm saying more is like seeing the different side of someone, or seeing, you're seeing when someone like reveals a part of them to you.
So like when behaviors don't match perceptions. Is that it?
Yeah. But that's judging a book by its cover.
Well, yes and no, right? I mean, if you have... Behaviors don't match perceptions. So, like, if you establish perceptions about somebody... all right. So, a lot of people would... You could use the comic book one, because it's not really... I guess kind of it is, but a lot of people, until I mention that I'm, like, a big comic book geek... Nobody would ever judge that. Nobody would ever expect that behavior based off of their perceptions of me initially. But I guess that kind of is judging a book by its cover.
And I love that you embrace that, though. I mean, like, if someone approached you about it, you wouldn't, like, you don't brush it off like, yeah, I kind of watch these movies. I'm like, no, you like these movies a lot.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, you're usually out, you know, seeing at least 3 times in the theaters, sort of thing. And that's awesome. And I love that you know that and you embrace that. And one of my favorite things you ever said about yourself, I'm complimenting you now because you've been a good friend recently. So don't take this to granted. I'm not going to do this all the time. Ooh. Honestly, fuck you after this episode. One of my favorite things we did, I remember when we first started the show, I posted a GIF on Big Deal Blake and we shared it, and it was us dancing.
Yes.
And I love that GIF. It's just us being goofs, and it's really funny.
Yeah.
And there was a comment on your wall. When you shared it on your wall, you had a comment, a friend, I didn't know who it was.
Yes.
And this woman said, you know, you got to be careful, like, about posting this in case like a girl sees this or someone sees it. And then you responded to this in a very professional, like very nice way. It's like, if a woman saw, if I would not be embarrassed if a woman saw this, if like if a woman saw this, they would say this as me and this is who I am. And the woman I want to talk to is the one who sees this and finds this funny and wants to get to know me more. Or said something along those lines. I don't know exactly what you said.
Basically, what I kind of just turned around on that kind of side snide comment that she made about it was.
But you weren't a jerk.
I wasn't, and it's on purpose. I'm never gonna I'm never gonna be a jerk to somebody if I don't have to be. Even if they are being kind of a jerk first, I just it's not what I do. It's I tend to talk my way through things, but. Basically, what I said was, if a girl sees this and wants to judge me based off of that goofy side of me, then I don't have time for that girl who can't embrace that goofy side of me, because I need somebody that has a similar goofy side that we can kind of just get along.
Absolutely.
Otherwise, there are just certain things about me that aren't going to change. Mm-hmm. And the girl that I find attractive that finds that attractive about me is a total win.
Right. And that's in a way... That's what I'm talking about, how I'm relating it to this topic, that it's just this perception of you that you could be this, you could take it, I guarantee you, we're not talking about examples, but I'm saying, I guarantee you there's a point in your life, in your working career, that you were hard ass at one point or a day or whatever it was. And it could have been to someone who didn't know you or something like that. And then they could see the side of you of like this complete, like Marvel loving, comic movie, you know, t-shirt wearing goofball, you know,
right. I
mean? That you have that side to you. It's not, it's a part of you. It's not exactly all that you are, but it's a part of you. And that's kind of like what I'm getting at. You know what I mean?
Yes.
I find that interesting that, you know,
I'm trying to think of a good way to, but I honestly don't know that there is not really a better way to say, don't judge a book by its cover.
I know it's kind of like, I guess what we could say is don't judge a book by its cover, but there's different facets of that. There's
right.
different ways to say it. So you could say it physically, like I said, alluded to before. You have, a straight up like a suit, and you figure this suit's just this white man conservative, works in the finance district, but this guy could really be wearing a suit because he just is going to a funeral, or he, his career may be that what you actually described, but he's a surfer, video game player, whatever. You know
right.
what I'm saying? Like, use the
almost,
side.
I mean, it, and it's kind of a hand-in-hand statement, but almost kind of like, don't assume anything about anyone until you've walked a mile in their shoes. It's almost kind of the same thing,
sure.
but it scratches at something beyond the surface, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because in order to truly know that person, you can make judgment calls about them that could be totally wrong, but in order to know that person... if you only see them at the surface, you might have to actually experience them and figure out what is going on in their life.
And what about adding on to this now, like seeing a different side of someone that you've known for a long time? You know what I mean? Like think about, I could think of it like an early memory I have with my grandpa. Like my grandpa was the hard ass, you know, I'm talking, he was a hunter, fisher, whittler, tobacco chewing, baseball watching, Rambo loving son of a bitch, right? And then you see him be like this like goofy son of a bitch, not a lot, but every once in a while you just see him do like something really goofy. Like he'll pop his teeth out, you know, and be like bah, 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 to the kids or something like that. You know
yeah.
what I mean? Like the tough son of a bitch you thought like, you know, could walk through walls, you know, like spark matches on his facial hair, you know, but then you see him playing with a kid, like see this like innocent side to him. You know what I mean? Like that's,
yes.
that's like a general example.
Yeah, no. For me, I get that. Like, and most of the time I'm kind of at this point in life, I'm kind of used to being the boss in a workplace setting in a restaurant, but in times that I have
kicking down doors,
in times that I have not been the one in charge and I've just been kind of like a frontline soldier. I experience that when I get a manager to laugh, like when I get a person who is, you know, whose rank exceeds my own.
Say I'm the same exact
when
way.
when they're serious most of the time. If I say something and they just start cracking up, like it happened a lot with Tony Smith. Tony usually at work, Tony was always really serious.
Mm.
But he'd sum up and say something, and I'd just answer like that, and he would just start dying laughing, and I'd be like, got you, Tony. Yeah. Got you good.
I like that, too. I always have done that in the office environment. I love doing it to the higher-ups. Not my boss, but like my boss's boss, or like a CFO or a CMO or something like
because
that.
Because then they become a person.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Danny. Exactly. It's like we are people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And like I remember I cracked up my CMO about a month ago, and he was talking about we were just shooting the shit. And he says, do you guys date? And he was referring to you were talking about mobile apps and the online dating. And he's like, do you guys date because of this app or something like that?
Right.
And
right.
And I was like, oh, you actually meant like dates, like going out on dates. Like I'm in office mode talking to the CMO. Like I'm thinking about like scheduling a meeting or something like on the date calendar. And we started laughing. It's something like that. And it was hilarious because, you know, Danny's cracking up right now.
Sure.
Anyhow, internally, he's dying. Tears inside. He's crying internal tears right now. He has to go to the bathroom because all the tears are building up right now.
Right. Was really hoping you'd make some kind of food pun regarding dates and beets or, you know, figs or something.
I don't know. But it was something like that. I can't remember exactly what. But like, I love seeing that side and making people like, you know, we are an office environment. But seeing that side, that higher up, be like, you have a sense of humor. You need to in addition, you have to communicate to the people who you are in charge of. Like, yeah, we don't work directly together. You are in charge of three other people who are in charge of me. But even better, like, I'm still a product of what you're making right now. Like, I am, like, at the same time, you know what I mean?
Yeah, of course. But furthermore, where are we leading this overall to? What's the underlay? Is there a question? Is there an arc? Is there something specific you want to talk about in pertaining to this topic?
I can't.
Okay.
That's why I was saying I had to dance around a lot. I mean, I can't. It was an explicit example I said in the beginning, but
okay.
I'm just saying that.
What's the relevant importance of it?
Yeah, this is a topic, too. I kind of sprung on you, too, because it would have been better if you prepared for it. It's one of those. So a lot of times when we have topics on the show, we like to like spring it on each other so we have an honest reaction to it.
Right.
But sometimes a topic like this is something that you want to be a little bit prepared for of a specific memory or a person. And sometimes it's hard to think of something on the top of your head. But I do like the natural reaction.
Yeah, no. But, I mean, it happens. It happens throughout life. And it's kind of hard to escape the term don't judge a book by its cover, because it's kind of a blanket scenario term for what you're describing.
Sure.
In certain instances, that'll go a lot deeper. In certain, it's just a surface thing that works. Like, I've had in my career two guys who are security staff who are like really big brooding guys that I would never suspect ever to know anything that I'm talking about if I talk about comics. School me.
That's awesome.
And I one night, like when I was way years ago when I was a server, I was talking with like two of the three other guys. We'd all gotten off work, and it was like around the time that episodes 1 through 3 of Star Wars were coming out, and we were all talking about it and like planning to go see it and blah blah blah. And we had this security guy named Eric, who's just this like 6'8" giant guy. And he's just sitting there, like standing kind of like back against our table, like watching the bar area, because we were like at one of the last tables in the bar, like, you know, facing the dining room kind of. And one of the guys at the table is just like, God, Eric just wants to beat up all of us right now. And we all started cracking up, and he had a good laugh. And then he just turns around. He's like, well, you know, actually, most of what you guys are saying is accurate. But and he starts going into details about the Star Wars books.
Oh, that's awesome. I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. Last one, because we have to wrap this up. On the last couple episodes of the preamble, if I can't remember on the top of the head what number it was, but it was the episode when we're talking about 300 for the homage. We had special guest Brandon McGee on here. Great example of not judging a book by its cover. The guy is 6'6", like 250, 60-pound black guy who's bald, booming voice. And he loves anime. He loves comic books. And it's like,
I can talk to him about Dragon Ball.
Oh my God. Yeah. He, Speaking of which, Brandon, I don't know if you still watch any of these shows still, but I'm like halfway through Death Note, and God damn, is it good. Holy shit. If you can, if any of my viewers, if you watch anime or you want to give anime a chance, Death Note, holy shit, that show's good. But Brandon McGee is a great example of that, though. I think we got that topic across in a way, right? It was a little weird. It was a little weird one.
Yeah. No, I mean,
a little weird.
I mean, if it's just an arc thing that you kind of wanted to explore more, yeah. I mean, I would say that we definitely talked about it. If it's something that you want to dig into deeper at a later date and time, we can absolutely.
Well,
also,
I think that if you think about it more, I bet you can come up with like your brother, or you can come up with a story about your brother, like a different side of your brother you've never seen before, or you could talk about your one of your coworkers who you just thought, you know, and then you find out that like they really like this.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what? Or see a different side to them. It could be a negative thing too. It could be a negative thing where you talk about this and this person drops out like this like racist bomb and it's like, no.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck? Like, where the hell did this come from?
Right.
So, anywho, I think we got the point across. It's just I recently got impacted by that.
Yeah.
Danny.
Yeah. No.
Are you judging the book by its cover for High Noon?
As much as I love Westerns.
Wow.
Actually,
I'm cracking this up at the end of the podcast, everybody. I did that.
I actually think I like this beer better when it was cold, which is not the first time I've said this on this show.
You like it better when it's cold.
Yeah.
Okay. So the rubbing you should take back is what you're saying.
Yeah. No. The mixing up the yeast sediment in it, that'll have nothing to do with it. I mean,
but like, the warmth of your hands.
That's not going to really affect it.
My hands are really warm right now. It's hot day in Chicagoland.
I think I liked it a little bit better when it was cold. Overall, though, I mean, it's kind of rough to get the smell on it out of a can, but because you'll just basically be putting your nose into aluminum. But overall, flavor-wise, I liked it. I could definitely see drinking this on more hot summer days.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, it delivers pretty much what it promised. You had said earlier that the wheat malt presence was very strong, and it even says it on the can that most of the time hefs max out at 70% wheat malt, but this one gets over 90%. So this is like a really heavy misbalance of the wheat malt to your hops, which is, it doesn't finish bitter at all to me.
Zero.
Yeah.
Bitter. I'm talking 0% bitterness in this beer. That's what I was saying before, because that bitterness, I think, puts this halt to it when you're drinking this. I could seriously just drink this like water and just chug this beer.
Yeah.
I have like, it's like it puts this aftertaste where you just want to keep on drinking.
Yeah. No,
so we got to wrap this up. So where do you want to give this?
I get a little bit of pepper and citrus zest. I like it. I would give this 3.5.
Right on the money. Me too.
Yeah.
Three on the money. Mainly just because I think the aftertaste to this, it has such a, it's like a quenching your thirst sort of beer, if that makes sense.
If I had had this in a koozie and it stayed cooler, I probably would bump that up to a 4.
Interesting.
Yeah, because I really do think that I like this better when we first cracked it and it was like...
I agree.
It was like, you know, in the low 40s.
I'm talking about the guy who put, you know, little cubes in his whiskey. I like chill beverages. Yeah. That's how I am. However, you know, when we do dry January, every January, we got to review that coffee because coffee's, I mean, if I had to pick between coffee and beer, I'd pick coffee. I would. I should do new coffee. Instead of a brew with you, it's a Java with the Papa. I don't know. You're the Papas. Java with the lava.
That sounds dangerous. That sounds dangerous.
It's hot.
Sounds really dangerous.
Oh! Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining.
A coffee with a talkie. That was horrible.
I love horrible bad jokes, though. You know that.
I'm full of them.
I know. That's why we're friends.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been episode 46 of A Brew With You. You can find me, Big Deal Blake, on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, SoundCloud, iTunes, and you're probably watching this on YouTube, but you watch on SoundCloud too, or listen to SoundCloud too.
Please remember to go to patreon.com/bigdealblake if you want to get this episode a whole week early. And also to toss a few bucks to support the show. I'm jobless now.
Spare any change?
Yes, yes. Change, change, change. Danny.
Yes.
Where can the lovely people find you?
Y'all can find me at Danny A. Barajas on Twitter, at Danny Adam B on Instagram, and at Danny Adam on Snapchat. Just so if you don't follow me on Snapchat, you can still see my Instagram stories, because that's a thing now.
We're just doing some Instagram stories.
Yes.
Before the show. It's fun.
Yeah, we got to figure out how we get notifications for those.
Do we?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
I've never used it before. Why did they blend two apps?
Yeah, thank you, everyone. It's really weird. The YouTube ratings, look whatever, but SoundClouds are much higher recently. In addition, I'm getting a patron a month. Thank you, Danny, by the way.
Yes.
That means a lot, and it does. And, it's a very, very, very slow growing process, but it's growing, and that's huge. More special guests, a lot of cool stuff coming up.
I got at least three upcoming for us.
I'm fucking excited for that. Yeah. I went to Second City to see a show unrelated, and I ironically just ran into three people because I know a lot of people who work there, and I know a lot of the system. And I said, You want to do this? And I'm like, yep.
Good.
So, really funny people too. Yeah. Like, we're talking really good.
Is one that girl from Pants, because she was hysterical.
Oh, I should ask
show.
Her. I should ask her to do that. Yeah, she was funny. Thank you, everyone. Please, thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing, and telling a friend. It means a lot. And
indeed.
Remember, if you need alcohol delivered fast, in 20 minutes or less, not an hour less, 20 minutes or less, use Saucy.
Saucy, the gold
medal. They did not sponsor us for this, ladies and gentlemen.
But they have the gold medal of alcohol delivery
services. See, medal, it's a beer, the golden beer.
The golden beer.
The golden beer. Thank you, everybody. We'll see you next time.
All right, so Blake has now just gone to pick up Saucy. For the first time ever in this show, we are having alcohol delivered to Rio, which is clearly where we're broadcasting from. It's been an interesting experience. We're going to see what kind of quality of products they deliver, although I don't think that should be a problem. I'm pretty sure they have to deliver the real thing, provided he shows adequate ID. I do have kind of a problem with this service, though, because I just feel like there are so many ways to deliver booze to underage people. As an underage kid, like years ago, I probably would have loved trying to figure out how to work my way around this. However, as a responsible employee of a new bar company and venture, this makes me a little bit uncomfortable. But we'll see how it goes. In the meantime, I'm going to continue drinking some of this beer. I actually really like this. But if I had to go off on one more rant topic, and I'll do it real quick while Blake isn't here. Yes, I absolutely would have a fucking sweet man cave. For any of you who know me personally that watch the show, you know most of the stuff that I'm into. You probably know that Tony Stark is one of my heroes. If I had an overabundance of cash, there would be, hands down, no contest, an absurd amount of technology. Just the craziest things I could get my hands on top of some incredibly comfortable couches, probably insane gigantic 4K TVs that were 3D, all the best gaming systems, and all the old school gaming systems. Just to circle back around to our last week's topic, I would definitely have a functioning Nintendo. Oh, Blake, you're back.